Hey everybody, it's Alex with Engineering Applied. In this video, we're going to be taking a look at the combined tool in Autodesk Inventor. If you want more easy to understand and practical content like this, made by an experienced engineer like myself, make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on notifications so you don't miss out on any helpful content like this in the future. If you're looking for a specific function, check the description for timestamps. And if you don't find what you're looking for in this video, make sure you check out the other videos in my Autodesk Inventor series playlist because I know you'll find exactly what you need there. Let's get started. Okay, so let's jump right into the tutorial. So what you're looking at currently are two separate solid bodies. So our first solid body is the Engineering Applied logo. And the second solid body is this purple curved piece of material here. So if I hover over solid two in my model browser, you'll see that's outlined. And essentially what we're going to do is we're going to step through the different options in the combined tool and show you how those interact with the various part bodies in our model. So what we're going to do first is after we have our 3D geometry, we're going to go up to the modify section and click combine. Okay. And now it pulls up our little menu here. Let's start up at the top. And in the top left, we have our properties tab. So this is very similar to our extrude function, revolve, and so on and so forth. And if you don't already know now, if you click this little red X, it'll close out of that window. So let's jump back into the combine tool and move over to the right. We have this little plus sign, and that opens up some additional menus for us if we want to use those. And if we go all the way to the top right, this is our advanced settings menu. And in this case, all you'll find in here is the help menu access under the advanced settings menu. Some of the other functions have a couple other features hidden in those menus. So this is context specific. So depending on the tool you're using, it will give you different options based on those tools. Here, we can actually change the name of the feature on the fly. So currently its default name is combine. So if we were to hit okay on this command, so let me just pick up a couple of bodies here and hit okay. And if we look over in the model browser, you'll see combine. Now it's labeled combine too, because I was doing some testing and it already took up the first combine slot. So this is the next one in line. Now, if we go back and do that again, we'll select the two features here or the two solid bodies. Okay, I can click in the space and change this to something else. So I can name this custom name one, just for example, hit enter. Okay, and then it enters that name for me. And then when we execute the command, you'll see that over here in our model browser, we have custom name one. Okay, so I'm back in my combine tool. I went ahead and undid that custom name that I just applied. And we want to take a look at the input geometry section. Now, there's two main bodies that we'll be selecting in this section. We have the base body and then the tool body. Okay, the base body is essentially the body that is acted upon by the tool body. So for example, I want to remove the Engineering Applied logo from this material, this purple material. So I would select this purple material as my base body. And to do that, you want to make sure your little selection box is active. So you see that little blue line, that means the base body selection is active, okay? So we'll pick up this purple curved surface. And then now you'll see my tool body selection filter is active with that little blue line. And I'll hover over the Engineering Applied logo and you'll see the entire solid body lights up. Okay, you can also select these entities from your model browser. You see my two solid bodies here on the left. Okay, so here in the output section, we have three main Boolean operations. We have the join Boolean operation, which simply combines two separate solid bodies and creates a single solid body. Our second Boolean operation is the cut operation, and that essentially removes the geometry that's designated as the tool body from the base body. So if we were to click that and hit okay, it'll remove the material from that space. Now let's actually jump back and do the same thing again, okay? And let's try the join operation. So if we do join and hit okay, it'll combine those two solid bodies into a single solid body. So if we go to the model browser, you see we only have a single solid left here. If I control Z or undo that, okay, we have our two solid bodies again. So that's what the join Boolean operation does. Now let's go back in one more time, click our base body and our tool body. Okay, the final Boolean operation is intersect. So all this does is it only keeps the geometry of the overlapping solid body. So if I click that and hit okay, you'll see it only retains the geometry between the intersection of the two solid bodies. Okay, the last option I want to show you is the Keep Toolbodies option. Now, to show this to you, what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick up my base body and my tool body once more. We're going to use the cut operation, and I want you to pay attention to the model browser and the fact that two solid bodies will go down to a single solid body. Okay, so if I just hit OK with this unchecked, you see that I'm left with my stock material with that little logo punched out of it, okay? Now, if we go back and do that again, so I'll just go ahead and click on that combine, check this option and hit okay, you'll see that we've retained the two solid bodies, but the tool body is just simply hidden. It's not actually removed from the model itself. So that's what that advanced property does for you. Now, before I wrap up this video, I want to talk about the selector style dropdown, and then I want to talk about the apply and create new combine button that's located in the bottom right-hand corner of this box, okay? So if we want to change the style of our selector here in the output section, all we have to do is hover over to this little arrow that's facing downwards, left click, and we can change this to a dropdown menu. Okay, so you see now it opens up as a dropdown menu instead of a series of icons. Now I prefer the icon, so I'm going to change it back to that. And now let's take a look at the apply and create new button. So first I'll select my base body and my tool body, and I'll just set a couple other options. Now, if we hit this little plus sign, essentially what's going to happen is we'll execute the command as if we hit the okay button, but it'll keep the command window open. So if we hit this little plus sign, you'll notice it keeps the window open. And this is here so that you can quickly move through your workflow without having to jump in and out as you're selecting new base bodies and tool bodies. That's all for this segment of the Autodesk Inventor part creation module, where we took a look at the combine tool. I really hope that you found this tutorial to be helpful and that you put what you've learned into practice so you can continue developing your skills as you work your way through these lessons. Also, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on notifications to stay up to date on future content that will help you reach your goals along your journey. And of course, don't hesitate to leave a comment or reach out via my website contact page and let me know if there's anything else you'd like to learn about or see on this channel. I really appreciate you choosing to stop by and learn with me, and I'll see you again soon.